Now if I look at vector A and I resolve this vector A into components, then here are the components. This is one component of it and this is another component. This component and this component are in the same direction. So if this is angle theta, which will be exactly the same as this theta, so here this theta, this is the theta starts from here and reaches the high part. So I resolve this into components. So this component is basically ax, which is equal to a cos of theta, and it is along the n unit vector direction. So I can write, if I write a dot b cross c, a dot b cross c, then this thing is equal, the component which is means the dot product, so it will be only the x component of a, and then b cross c is b c sine of the angle. And now here the ax here, which is in n unit vector direction, okay, this is, if I write this in the, this is in n unit vector direction, keep this in mind that this is just for the understanding, this is only a number, not a vector quantity. It is a cos theta, but it is in n unit vector direction. So this is also in n unit vector direction, and when n dot n comes in, n dot n, then this is equal to 1. So we have this a dot b cross c is equal to a and b c sine of the angle, and then cos of the angle ABC. Now AB cross C makes the base of it, and A cos theta is the height of it. So base into height means the area, this is the swept area multiplied with the height, and it gives us the A dot b cross c actually gives us the volume of this parallelogram. Volume of this parallelogram. Like first b cross c makes an area, and then we raise that area up by a cos theta, and this makes the volume of a parallelogram. There are some properties associated with the vector, with the scalar triple product. If I write a dot b cross c, then this is equal. I can do some cyclic permutations here. I can write, if I write b here first, then it will be c dot a. Then if I write b first here dot, then what it will be, b dot, then it will be a cross c, b dot, then a cross c. Similarly, if I write c here, then it will be dot, when c is here, then it will be b cross a. When it is C here, so it will be A cross B. And this is C dot A cross B. Now, if I change the dot and cross, so this is a permutation, understand this permutation. A dot, then B cross C. If it will be A cross C, it will be B times this one. And if it will be A cross B, it will be C times this one. Like, understand it here. B cross C makes the base of it, and then A cos theta makes the height of it. So it gives the volume. When it will be A cross C, so A cross C, it will give us this area, and then it will be a long B here. So it will give us the volume of this parallelogram. If it will be A cross B, so A cross B will be this face, and it will be C times this, so it will go this way in order to get the volume of this one. So one of it will make the face of it, while the other vector will move it along that direction in order to give the volume. We can have this one in another form as well, that if I write it is, I reverse this one, like I write C cross B. Then we know that when we reverse the order, then minus sign will come here, and this is A dot, but the same minus will come here if I move, I just reverse this one, like C cross A. So another minus sign will come here, and this minus will cancel with this minus. Similarly, I can write C dot B cross A. So it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, means the result is the same. It doesn't matter, you say B cross C and then you move it up, or you say C cross B and then you move it down the same length, so it doesn't matter, you will get the same volume for this one. So it can give us the volume of a parallelogram, the volume of a parallelepiped, or even a pyramid volume we can calculate this way with this. And now I can write them in the matrix form as well, that A dot B cross C is equal to, in this form I can write, when I was writing B cross C, then I wrote X unit vector, Y unit vector and Z unit vector, multiplied this B cross C, the BX, BY, BZ and CX, CY, CZ I wrote here. So I will write these as it is, B cross C, so it is the old one, BX, BY and BZ here, and CX, CY and CZ here. This is B cross C. Now when I will write it is a dot product here, so means the resultant will be a scalar quantity here. So instead of X, Y and Z unit vector, I will write the components of A here. So this is AX, AY and AZ here. And this will give me the volume. This is a determinant, not a matrix. So I know how to calculate the determinant, like AX multiplied all this, and we will find this result. Now what if I change this one? Like for example, I write A dot B cross C. For example, I write A dot, and I first multiply it with B, and then cross C. So here this is meaningless, because A dot B will give us a scalar, means a number. A number cannot be multiplied with a vector as a cross product. Only two vectors can be multiplied as a cross product. So this is meaningless. We can write A times B with no cross product, just the ordinary multiplication C. So it is just like multiplying a vector with a scalar number. So this is to be noted, that it is meaningless to have this thing. Now we will discuss the vector triple product. So in vector triple product, we will multiply three vectors and such that the result is a vector quantity. And let's say we consider three vectors, A cross two vectors B cross C. First, B cross C is multiplied is a vector product, and it generates a vector, means generates an area with a certain direction, and then it is again cross multiplied with vector A. So it will give us a vector triple product. The result will be a vector. So it is, keep in mind that it is not a volume. The scalar triple product is a volume. This is not a volume because it is area, and then that area you sweep along to form another area. So this is not a volume, and this thing we do calculate with a rule which we call the Bacb rule. Like B vector simply multiplied with a number, and that number is A dot C minus K, and this is C times another number, which is the result of A dot B. So this we call, in short, is the Bacb rule, and this is also true for this one, that we can change the order. Like for example, I just write this one is, let's say I write, instead of this one, A, B cross C is multiplied first, I multiply A and B first, and then I cross product it with C. So it will be equal to minus C cross A cross B, because dot product, the cross product is not commutative. And then this will be equal to minus times, now again apply that rule, that it will be A times B dot C. So minus A times B dot C plus B and A dot C. So it will be equal to this one. We can write this, like for four vectors we can do this thing. If I write A is multiplied with B, then it's a vector quantity, and I dot product this one with C, with two other vectors, C cross D. And this will be equal to A dot C. Like A dot C, then A dot C, and then B dot D. B dot D, and then there will be alternate minus A dot D. So alternate we will multiply them, A dot D and then B dot C. So the important thing is that we can calculate the volume with a scalar triple product. Vector triple product is just the multiplication of three vectors. Similarly, we can write three vectors in this form as well. Like A is a cross product with B, which is already is a cross product with C cross D. So this is also one of the possibility that we can multiply here. So this will be equal to B multiplied, not as a dot and cross, just simple multiplication, A dot C cross D. C cross D, and another bracket here for this one, minus A dot B multiplied with C cross D. So look here, C cross D will generate a vector. Vector multiplied is a dot product, since we just generate a scalar product, so a number. Number can be multiplied without any dot and cross with a vector is a scalar multiplication we have already discussed. And here it's a scalar number and multiplied with a vector. So these are the various possibilities we can do with the cross product.